Bleach Episode 4 spoilers have come in from the official website with some screenshots, and we are going to get into this because this is a very well anticipated episode. So, stick around. As said in the intro of this video, this episode is going to be very much focused on because there is a big character of which everyone's excited to see, and that is Byakuya. And this is probably not only from the manga readers, but the fact that we see this within the trailer as well with that beautiful Zenbon Zakura shot that we saw. It looks gorgeous. We are excited to see how it's going to go down. We have one of the core staff on this episode as well, which is going to be very exciting. And it's going to be a fast-paced episode, and for the right reasons at that too. But before we get into that, I do want to discuss these images that we do see, one being Harshwild, which we saw at the end of the last episode, being episode 3, so nothing really special going on there. These screenshots unfortunately are for the majority of the trailers that we have already seen, but except for maybe the Asnote one, because that looks a little bit different than what we've seen currently. We get the Bambietta shot, which is beautiful that we're going to get her. I don't think she's going to get much screen time, but hey, we take it. Then we get Toshiro, which again we saw in the trailer as well, his fight with another Quincy, looking like he's been backed up into a corner here, so it's interesting to see what he's going to do there. We have, of course, Byakuya with the Zenbon Zakura shot that we saw from the trailer, and Asnote, which seems to me that he's going to get a Zenbon Zakura thrown at the face. So these are very interesting screenshots. But just a quick synopsis of what is going to be going down in this episode. The synopsis says, "The battle to destroy the Soul Society by the Vandanarike has begun. Within the Sarutei, several gigantic fire pillars of Reishi rose up. The 13 court guard squads, who have allowed the enemy forces, the Knights of the Starcross, to invade the court, will soon suffer a great number of casualties. A captain-level Shinigami joins the front line, but the enemy's attack doesn't go through, and the battle situation doesn't improve. The captains, including Byakuya Kuchiki, are determined to break the bankai in order to overcome the situation. But... It is Google Translate, but we pretty much get the idea of what's going to happen. You know, there's nothing inherently wrong with this translation. Just a bit of iffy buts here and there. I did, in fact, skim the chapters in preparation for this episode, and it seems that we are going to be getting a 5-chapter episode, which is completely fine considering the context of these chapters are majority fight after fight after fight after fight, except for the start and the last part of those chapters. You know, it's going to be really interesting to see what they do. I'm actually surprised if they were to do a 1-to-1 manga adaptation here, it would probably take them maybe 10 minutes. So I'm really excited to see what choreography they do, and I'm just overall excited to see what they can do to elevate this invasion. And you know, from what we've seen from the trailers, you know, the camera movements on Asnot, which I will say, Halloween is coming up on the 31st of October, so it's a perfect episode for Asnot to really join into this one. It's going to be just interesting and just a big, massive creative standpoint to see what the animators can really bring to the table on this. And I'm just overall very excited to see each of the captains, majority the main 4, maybe 5 captains that are probably going to be struggling throughout this fight. I mean, it already seems like they're going to do some stuff with Byakuya, considering from the trailers that we got, and maybe Toshiro too. It seems like maybe he's going to get a little bit more choreography given by the trailers that I've seen. But I mean, look, Toshiro got done dirty a little bit, so I hope that he can perform a little bit more. That's the same with Soifon and the rest of them. Also, we did see a lot of Soifon as well, so I'm very excited to see, you know, not only the conclusion or a carry-on fight with, you know, Ichigo versus Kurge, because that's still going on if you guys don't remember. We've also got like 5-ish fights potentially happening in this episode, maybe even more. You've also got to remember all the Soul Reapers that are probably going to be taking so much area damage as well during this whole invasion. So it's going to be an extremely action heavy episode, and I think the team that we have at the moment on this episode is going to be pretty strong. And dare I say, I think this might be the best episode that we've had out of the 3 currently. And to be fair, all 3 have been really good. I mean, 2 especially was amazing. I really love that. The comeback was the comeback. Episode 3 was pretty standard, enjoyed that, but I think episode 4 might be the strongest. We'll have to see, but stakes are only getting higher from here, and you can tell that through each episode that the stakes are getting higher, and I'm excited to see where this goes. So I'll pose off the question to you guys: what fight are you interested to see the most? Are you interested to see Soifon do some bits? Are you excited to see Byakuya do his bits? Are you excited to see Toshiro? Who else was there? Come on, Mora versus Bambietta, because we saw that in the trailer. I don't feel like I'm ready for next episode, if I'm honest with you, but with that being said, I am going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Jaymes Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.